we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section linear algebra, and the problem is on the properties of idempotent matrix and its eigen spaces. And this problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, let M belongs to M suffix n over R with M not equal to 0 matrix and the identity matrix, but M square is equal to M. Which of the following statements are true? We are given 4 options. Option 1, the null space of M is the eigen space of M corresponding to the eigen value 0. Option 2, let X belongs to the column space of M with X not equal to 0, then X is an eigen vector of M corresponding to the eigen value 1. Option 3, let X does not belong to the null space of M, then X is an eigen vector of M corresponding to the eigen value 1. Option 4, R power n is equal to column space of M plus the null space of M. So we are given M belongs to the vector space of all n by n matrices with real entries, where M is not a zero matrix and M is not an identity matrix, but M square is equal to M. That means M is an idempotent matrix. So that is, M is a non-zero, non-identity, real idempotent matrix of order n. It is known that the only possible eigenvalues of an idempotent matrix are 0 and 1. This is a very standard result. We all know this. Now, E lambda, the eigenspace of M corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda, by definition, it is the subspace of R power n consisting of all eigenvectors of M corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda together with the zero vector. This is the set of all X belongs to R power n. The eigenvectors are obtained like this: M minus lambda I times X is equal to 0. So such X are eigenvectors. So that is our E lambda. And we have to talk about E0, the eigenspace of M corresponding to the eigenvalue 0, E1 corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. And that is figuring in this example. Let's now see the validity of the statement that is given in option 1. Null space of M is the eigen space of M corresponding to the eigen value 0. That means we want to show that the null space of M is equal to E0. We have the null space of M, that is the set of all X belongs to R power n, Mx is equal to 0. This is the definition of the null space of M. This is also called the kernel of M. And E0, we have seen the eigen space of M corresponding to the eigen value lambda is equal to 0. And it is the set of all X belongs to R power n, M minus lambda I, lambda is 0, M minus 0 I X is equal to 0. That is, X belongs to R power n, Mx is equal to 0, the set of all such things. And this is precisely this one only. That is the null space of M. That is equal to the null space of the matrix M, that is null M. So, null M is the eigenspace of M corresponding to the eigenvalue 0. This is true. Thus, the option 1 is true. Let's now get into the next option. Option 2, let x belongs to the column space of M with x not a, a zero vector, then is x an eigenvector of M corresponding to the eigenvalue 1? That's the question. We have the column space of M by definition is the set of all Mx, x belongs to R power n. This is by definition column space of M. And even we have seen the eigenspace of M corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda is equal to 1. That is the set of all x belongs to R power n. M minus lambda I, lambda is equal to 1, M minus I x is equal to 0. That is x, the set of all x belongs to R power n, mx is equal to x. Mx is equal to x. Now, if you take a x belongs to the column space of mx not equal to 0, can we show that x belongs to even? So x belongs to column space of m, x not equal to 0 implies x is equal to m y for some y belongs to R. Yes. Pre-multiply both sides by m, we'll get mx is equal to m square y. That will imply mx is equal to m square is m because m is an idempotent matrix. Mx is equal to my, but my is equal to x. So we'll get mx is equal to x. That means x belongs to e1. So x belongs to the column space of m implies x belongs to e1. So x is an eigenvector of m corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. Thus, the statement that is given in option 2 is true. The option 2 is true. But here we have a something very important to note down. That is the column space of M is equal to E1? And we have already here X belongs to the column space of M implies X belongs to E1. That is the column space of M is contained in E1, we have already proved. What about the reverse? Conversely, X belongs to E1 means mx is equal to x means what? X is equal to mx. Mx means it belongs to column M, column space of M. So x belongs to E1 implies x belongs to the column space of M. That is, E1 is contained in column space of M. Combining these two things, we'll get the column space of M is precisely E1. Agreed. Let's get into the third option. It says, let X does not belong to the null space of M, then X is an eigenvector of M corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. That means X does not belong to null space of M means E0. X does not belong to E1. Can this X be belong to E1? X does not belong to the null space of M. This is E0, E0. X does not belong to E0. Then can the X belongs to E1? That is the question. And this looks to be not true. So we give a counter example. Let us take M is equal to the 2 by 2, 1, 0, 0, 0. M is not a zero matrix. M is not an identity matrix. But M square is equal to M. So therefore, M is a non-zero, non-identity, real idempotent matrix of order 2, n is equal to 2. So now let's calculate the null space of M, that is the set of all x belongs to R square, mx is equal to 0, that is the set of all column vectors x1, x2 belongs to R square into M into the vector x is the 0 matrix. Now multiply, you will get x1 is equal to 0. And x2 becomes arbitrary, x2 is arbitrary. That means it is the set of all solutions are x2 times 0, 1, where x2 is arbitrary. That is, it is the subspace generated by 0, 1. We have E1, the column space of M, that is mx, x belongs to R square, and solving, we get x1 times 1, 0, where x1 is arbitrary, it is the set of all. So it is the subspace generated by 1, 0. So the null M, that is E0, is this one. E1 is this. So we have seen the null space of M is this, E1 is this. So let's now consider a X does not belong to null space of M. It is 1 comma 1 does not belong to null space of M, because 1 comma 1 is not a multiple of 0 comma 1. Now, if you believe that the option 3 is true, then 1, 1 must belong to E1, but it is not so. Why? Because it is not a multiple of 1 comma 0. So therefore, 1 comma 1 does not belong to E1. 1 comma 1 does not belong to E1. So then 1 comma 1 does not belong to null space of M. 1 comma 1 does not belong to E1. So the option 3 is not true. Now, to move further, we require a result. That result is the following. If M is an idempotent matrix, then the column space of I minus M is equal to the null space of M is equal to E0. This is very easy to prove. And this result is required to prove the next result. Proof. X belongs to the null space of M implies mx is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to x minus mx, that is I minus m into x. So I minus m into x is equal to x means x belongs to the column space of I minus m. So x belongs to the null space of m implies x belongs to the column space of I minus m. Therefore, the null space of m is contained in column space of I minus m. Conversely, x belongs to the column space of I minus m implies x is equal to I minus m into w for some w. Yes, because it's the column space of I minus m. That is, x is equal to w minus mw. Pre-multiply both sides by m. Mx is equal to m times w minus mw. That is equal to mw minus m square w. But m square is m because m is an idempotent matrix. Therefore, mw minus mw is equal to 0. That is, mx is equal to 0. So, if x belongs to column space of I minus m, then mx is equal to 0. That means x belongs to the null space of m. So, every element of I minus column space of I minus m is also an element of null space of m. Therefore, it is a subset. Column space of I minus m is a subset of null space of m. Combining this with the above one, we get the equality. The column space of I minus m is equal to null space of m. The null space of m is E0. That's the result. What we require for the next option. Lastly, we have the fourth option. R power n, n is equal to the column space of m plus the null space of m. Now, we see column space of M is a subspace of R power N. Null space of M is a subspace of R power N. Column space of M plus null space of M is a subspace of R power N. If U and V are subspace of a vector space V over a field F, then U plus V is also a subspace. So, column space of M plus null space of M is a subspace of R power N. Therefore, column space of M plus the null space of M is contained in R power M, R power N. We prove the reverse of it. Conversely, every vector X belongs to R power N can be written as X is equal to MX plus I minus M times X. MX and minus MX cancels. IX is X. So, this is true. And what is this MX? So, where mx belongs to the column space of m, correct, I minus mx belongs to the column space of I minus m, which is we have just now proved it is equal to null space of m. So, that means this mx belongs to the column space of m and this belongs to the null space of m. That is, x belongs to the column space of m plus the null space of M. So X belongs to R power M is implies X belongs to column space of M plus null space of M. So R power N is contained in column space of M plus the null space of M. Combining this with the earlier result, we get the equality. Therefore, R power N is equal to column space of M plus null space of M. So there's the option 4 is true. So far, only the option 2 is, option 3 is not true. Therefore, the options 1, 2 and 4 are true. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section linear algebra, and the problem is based on the properties of the idempotent matrices and its eigenspaces. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem. I wish you all the best. Thank you.